me here. They thought they were setting me up, but they don't understand. He said, I prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemies. So what they're going to do is watch me get anointed. What they're going to watch me do is blow up. What they're going to watch me do is get the power of God manifested on my life, because I'm standing in the fire. I'm going to be like Daniel. God, shut the lion mouth. You shut every lion mouth in your life. That's why you got to stand in the pressure. You complaining about the pressure, and God said, I'm molding you and making you. I'm making you to be the prophetess unto the nation. I'm making you to be the ambassador to foreign nations. I got to trust you. I got to let you be afflicted. I got to let you go through, because I want to know, are you going to turn your back?
Yes, my God.
Are you going to turn back because you say the fire too hot? The Bible tells me that he told Abraham, I want you to take the child that you waited for 20 plus years to get. I want you to go kill him. See, God is coming after your Isaac. He's coming after your Isaac. He want to know, will you give that what's precious to you? Will you give it back to me? But you trying to hold on. This my only child. God, this my business. God, I can't do this. And God said, but you don't love me. He said, oh, well, you got to love your mother, your father, your husband, your wife. You got to love them more than me. You got to love me more than them. You can't give God your children. Because see, it's a place where you can give God your children and you don't worry about it. Because I don't told God, I ain't worried about it, because God already delivered them. Whatever I see stuff that ain't right, they already delivered. I refuse to be moved by what I see, because I got the wisdom of God. We trying to fix stuff, and you ain't anointed to fix it. Come on here. You think I'm going to leave the throne room of heaven to go mess with a little foot neck demon? I'm seated in heavenly places. I ain't going to come down. You know, in the military, you got a lieutenant colonel. They don't know you from a can of paint. They got full-blooded colonels, and they can see you in the rain. Come on here, and you have on an umbrella. Come on here. You a prophet. They don't know you, and they got you with you go, they got an umbrella. You don't want nobody to see you. That person that don't know you from a can of paint will tell you, drop them. Get on your knees right now on this floor, and I want you to give me 50 push-ups in front of everybody. Don't do it if you don't want to. They can take your money. Take your money and your rank. So you think in the spirit realm,
come on, Pastor, keep it real, now.
I'm going to fuss. I'm going to let them know. I'm going to let them know you can't do this to me, baby. Keep on going. I ain't going to come off the throne. I don't think I'm better than you, but I know who I am.
My God.
I'm not from the leave heaven to come on earth to mess with a demon that ain't about nothing. Because we're changing our lives. Think about what we do, y'all. We're acting a fool because two people in your life have made you upset and you ruining your whole life.
My God.
You mean to tell me because mama got on your nerve, daddy got on your nerve, you can't have no healthy relationship because you refuse to forgive them? Devil, you a liar. Hey, that means I can't get in no marriage because I'm going to have problems. I can't get in no kind of friendship with women because I got problems, because they did. You let this affect your life all because of one person. Baby, you ain't that mama ain't that important to me. For real. Because I understand she only can do if it was her job just to get me here, she did her job. I can't make her be no better cracker because your mama was there for you. She prayed over you and all of that, but that was your portion. My mama portion wasn't there to do that. So I can't be mad at her because she didn't do that. So therefore, I got to be healed of that, and I got to tell the devil the wisdom of God, saying, I got to let her go. Because I see that the enemy is going to come after me with every relationship that's a female I'm going to have a problem with. And then it's going to cause me having a problem with me because I still won't let go of my hope. This is one of our main problems in the body of Christ, because we feeling like we got a right. When Jesus died, he nailed it to the cross. Amen. So if he nailed it to the cross, who are you to hold on to it?
Amen.
The wisdom of God said you gotta let it go. Because I got bigger fish to fry. I know I got a women ministry. Come on here. I know I got other women I need to help. But right now, while I'm still holding on to mama, I can't help nobody. The wisdom of God saying, even though I'm uncomfortable, even though I don't like it, but this is how I get free. Because here, look, God is bragging on you. He said, and the Lord said unto say, how thou not consider my servant Job, that there is none like him on earth, a perfect and an upright man. So you got to understand, God just gave me the revelation. Job wasn't just, God prophesied over Job's life. Job hadn't even got to that place, but God said what was written in the book. So he already said, Shanyada is a prophetess to the nations. Come on here. She walked in strength and she walked in power. So he said, say, try her. You haven't walked into no place yet, but he wants Satan to try you, because the same try you, he's going to push you to what he called you to be.
That's right. Amen.
That's why we got to go through, because through the process of going through, it's going to deliver you. It's going to transform you. But if you fight your enemy, what you're doing is stopping your growth. See, we fighting for a person that's pushing us. I thank God for my haters. They're pushing me to my destiny. They're pushing me to where I need to go. I'm for real. That's how I got anointed, is through my haters.
That's right.
Because for the simple fact, if they weren't after me, if they weren't playing against me, I wouldn't be praying.
Woo, you got to say it.
You mad at these folks and they making you pray. You